So hello everyone, this is CA Sanidhya Saraf, your friend, mentor and coach. So I believe that you all are doing great and you have started your preparations in full swing for the upcoming CA final examinations, right? So now this video is very, very important for all the students who have opted for economic laws as their elective paper. I am recording this video entirely in English so that even my friends from South India, even my students from South India, even they can get benefited, because the message that I'm giving in this video is very, very important, right? So regarding economic laws paper 6D, many queries I'm getting from many days, and the queries are with respect to many matters. So I decided to make a video so that the confusions can be cleared out. So mostly the queries that I'm getting is regarding the ICS study material. So the old edition of ICS study material has undergone several changes. The new study material that the ICI has released, so that is very bulky in comparison with the old study material. For example, IBC code. In the earlier study mat, it was of 100 pages. Now it's of 200 pages. So it has almost doubled. So sir, what's the reason of those changes? Are there significant amendments in economic laws? Because, you know, 100 pages in IBC earlier, now 200 pages. That's a significant change, right? So are there significant amendments? What to do regarding the new ICS study material? If we have the old study material, can we use the old study material, or it is important for us to use the new study material? So this is one of the query that I'm getting. Another is regarding the case laws. Sir, there are a lot of judicial pronouncements in economic laws. Lot of judicial pronouncement. If you go through the ICS study material, there are a lot of judicial pronouncements that is given. In the website also, Institute has separately released a booklet for the case laws. So how to go about the case law thing? Third, sir, in Jan 22, ICI has released a new case study digest file, right? So supposingly, if I have already done the old case study digest file that the ICI earlier released, so is there a significant difference between both? Sir, if I already have your question bank that you have given to us in the with the classes, so then are we required to refer this case study digest? So these are the kind of questions I'm getting. And fourth is the amendments. Sir, how many amendments are there in economic laws? Should we worry because of the amendments? So these are the four questions that I'm getting, and one by one we are going to see them. Firstly, regarding the ICS study material. So see, what are the kind of changes that has come in the new ICS study material as compared to the old edition? Point number one, basically there are many changes in which the content is exactly the same, only they have enabled better presentation. The same concept, they have depicted that in a better presentation. So basically what happened is that earlier the content was just given in the para form, now they have given in the tabular form. Earlier they used to give like point 1, 2, 3, 4, now they have given subsection 1, 2, 3, 4. So better presentation, some new charts included, then elaboration of few concepts. Earlier there were few concepts that was just covered up in 4 to 5 lines, and now they have elaborated some concepts, like they have given the same concept in 1 page, 1.5 pages. Approximately 130 case laws have been added. So a lot of case laws have been added. If you see, like in IBC code, you ask me, sir, earlier there were 100 pages and now there are 200 pages. The main reason is that 100 case laws are added in IBC. Yani out of the 130 case laws that are newly added in the study material, 100 case laws are from IBC. Right. So nearly 130 case laws have been added. And because of these reasons, the pages have increased. Let me clarify, there are no significant amendments. There are no significant amendments. The pages have increased because of these three reasons and not because of any significant amendments. The concepts still remain the same. But I still advise you that even if you were using old study material earlier, it is always better that take out the printouts of the new study material. Right? Use the new study material. This is the open book examination. It's always better to take the updated content in your hand. And one of the most important things that is needed for the elective paper is the master index. So you don't need to refer the index that is given in the study material, because that is not so comprehensive. I have rather given you a master index that is very comprehensive for exams, and that is going to help you out. So that master index you can download from www.apnamental.com in the free resources segment, and you can use that master index with the revised study material. Now, second thing is regarding the case laws. Sir, what to do regarding the case laws? See, one thing I will like to tell you. If you see the total number of case laws that is given by the ICI, in the study material itself, they have included around 150 case laws. Plus, in the website, they have given another 70 case laws are around. So total, if you see, there are approximately 220 to 230 case laws. And what is the weightage of case laws? There is no separate weightage. Maximum to maximum, you can get questions up to 4 to 8 marks. And those will be application-based questions. It will be not be a separate question only on case law. It's like suppose there is a judicial pronouncement on Section 7 of IBC. Now, if that question comes, even if you don't remember that judicial case, still you can write the answer as per Section 7. In that particular situation, you might get 2 out of 4 marks. But it's not that you are going to get 0 out of 4 marks. So maximum marks that the case laws are going to carry is 4 to 8 maximum. In that too, you can get the step marks even if you know the concepts. So is it really advisable to go through 250 case laws in so much of details, in so much of depthness, just for 4 to 8 marks? And in this 8 marks too, you can get step marks for the concepts. I will not advise you. What I will advise you is that for now, ignore the case law part completely. Don't make it complicated for yourself. Just go by the provisions. Section by section approach. Just go by the provisions. Okay, this is the section. This is the gist of the section. Just focus on concepts for now. Regarding case laws, you don't need to worry. Instead of going here and there, referring some case laws from the study material, some case laws from the website. So instead of, just rushing things here and there, I'll be providing you a complete case law file. Now that case law file will be a proper case law file, which will also include a proper index of the case law. So it's just like that if you just refer the case laws for once and you refer the index along. So in the exam, if any question comes on that, you can have an idea, okay, I studied that case law once and the reference of that is there in the index of the case law file. And from the index, you can get into the case law and you can write in the exam. So I will give you a complete case law file with a proper index, marking of important case laws, plus the summary of important case laws. Everything I'll be providing you. So for that, I need time, right? Because there are a lot of work in hand. For that, I need time. You'll be surely provided before the examination with ample number of days before the examination. So at least 1 month before the examination, you'll be surely provided with that file. So have patience for that. For now, just go by the concepts and the case law file you can refer at last, right? Then we have case study digest that was released for the released in Jan 22. So see, in the earlier case study digest, there were 50 questions, and in the new case study digest, there are 55 questions. So apparently, it feels that 5 new cases have been added. But still, I have to go through the file once to see whether any old questions have been deleted, and instead of that, there are new replacements, or it is just that the 50 questions are the same and 5 new cases are added. In any ways, you don't need to worry. If till now you have not started practicing questions, then you don't need to worry at all. You just need to refer the new case study digest, plus the questions given in the RTP, MTP past examinations paper. And if you already did the case study digest, or if you already have purchased my classes and you have got the question bank, so my question bank basically covers everything. The case study digest, the RTP, the MTP, the past exam question, everything. So in that particular scenario, what I'll be doing is that I'll be just giving you a list of questions separately. Ki, okay, in the new case study digest issued by the ICAI, these are the new questions that is not included in my question bank. So I will provide you separately that on Telegram channel. So you can refer that from there. So you don't need to worry. And finally, amendments. No need to worry about the amendments. As I told you, the changes are only because of the presentation reasons, the new concepts, the new case laws. There are no significant amendments. When the RTP comes, we have to check it out. But only minor amendments are expected in the RTP as well. So you don't need to worry about amendments. See, so regarding the significant changes that is there in the ICS study mat, I have given you a detailed file. I am sharing with you a detailed file in my Telegram channel, that is CS Anitya Saraf. The link of Telegram channel is there. You can join the Telegram channel. So I am sharing you with you a detailed file on the significant changes. So it's a very detailed file. I have highlighted each and everything regarding what are the additions, what is the kind of addition, topic by topic, comparison by comparison. I have given you the insights of all the kind of changes in the old edition of study material versus the new edition of study material for anyone who wants to refer, or simply ignore the old study material and get started with the new study material. That's the simplest advice. For the case law, I told you don't need to worry, just ignore it for now. Exam se pehle, I'll be shorting it out. Case study digest ke liye, I told you amendments ke liye, you don't need to worry about it. I'm there. So finally, one thing I will like to say, tension not yaar. If Sanitya sir is here, there is nothing to fear. I will be guiding you till the last. I'm there with you for your support. And I'm very much sure you are going to do wonders in audit law and economic laws paper 16. Even in the recent attempt, the results have come. Students have done wonderfully well in economic laws paper 60. 10 plus students have got 80 plus, 86, 85, 84, 83. Nearly 150 students have got 70 plus. So that's a remarkable thing. students are actually, getting such marks in the subject that it is kind of helping them to clear their second group and helping their CA examinations, helping to clear their CA examinations. So don't worry, all those kind of guidance you will get from me, and we are sure, I'm sure that we are going to rock in the May 22 exams as well. Right? Hum honge kamyab. And we are going to get great marks. We are going to secure very high marks. So don't need to worry, I'm there. I will be taking care of everything. One more thing, master index download from apnamental.com. Comprehensive significant changes file I'm sharing in my Telegram channel, so you can get it immediately now itself. Case study digest, nothing to worry, I'll be providing you those additional questions list separately, not included in my question bank. For those who have not started questions practice yet, then for them there is nothing to worry anyways. Amendments, only minor amendments are expected, and there is nothing to worry about, right? So this is all that I had to share. So this is a very, very important video for the students. Kindly share it with all your friends. Kindly share it with the masses so that everyone can get the benefit out of it. And don't forget to use the master index I'm giving you. That is going to be immensely wonderful for you. That is going to be a very high, that is going to be a utility file that is going to completely change the game of economic laws for you. Right. So don't forget to refer that. One more thing, I will try that all my revisionary audios that are available in Hindi, I will also try to ensure that those comes out in English for the next examinations, so that even my friends from South India are benefited. So all the very best. Love you all. Take care.